Welcome back. In a minute and a half, we begin the Racing Kings tournament. Apparently, we're playing for 2 hours, playing 3-minute Racing Kings. The goal is to get your king to the other side of the board, subject to the restriction that you cannot put your king in check. You cannot put your opponent's king in check. And this allows you to hang your pieces in all kinds of fun and creative ways. Here, let's put the music sound theme on, just for extra effect. Or should I say added effect? Added sounds much more pleasant than extra. So, oh, and note, on the 15th of this month, there will be a 24-hour Hyperbullet tournament. So, get all hyped for that, because I'm sure some awesome players are going to be playing in it, and I just might be watching. Although, honestly, who cares if I'm watching? You can watch the other players, like, comment as they play. That's the key point. So that's a couple weeks from now, I think. Oh, here we go. Here we go. It's like, I bet I'm not going to win the tournament. That'd be a pleasant surprise if that happened. But let's see how well we can do. Whew. All right. Ooh, that's dramatic. Okay. What are the odds that this early in the tournament I get paired way up? Alright, so he cannot capture my queen because that would be check. So I've protected my queen. Now if I did rook takes knight, he could take my queen there, which would be unpleasant. So let's get this out of here. King h3. I might want to counter just by keeping. Let's run the king forward as quickly as we can. Just let the simple strategy prevail here. Just run, run, run. Okay. And so now the other half of this game is figuring out when to capture your opponent's pieces. I'm just going to take this knight, because I think it might pose problems for me later. Note that the bishop can't move, and also the queen can't take this. Both cases, that would be a check for that to occur. Alright, let's go, go, go! This knight is still pinned. Do I take his rook? Or do I keep running? I'm not sure. This is one hell of a round one pairing, gotta say. Especially considering I have not played this variant in forever. And I'm not an expert to begin with. This is an incredible first round pairing. Okay. Let's stop that king from going too far. If it does manage to make it much further up the board, then I'll have to consider what to do about that at that time. It's looking like I might be able to draw this, especially because this knight is pinned down. It's challenging for white to make any progress. Basically, the most he can do is like capture my bishop, and that, I'm not sure that that helps him. In the meantime, like, he can't play queen e8 because that would be check. He can't move the knight because that would be check. And if you move the bishop, that doesn't really help him stop my king's advancing, I don't think. Note again that in the rules of this game, I cannot check his king. So I can't force him to go backward at all. I can just only plot my own course forward. And hang as many pieces as I can along the way, honestly. Having a rook behind a king is a strong thing to do in general. Because, well, the king protects the rook. Okay, so I see he's planning to block with queen f7 and then run his king forward. But I'm not sure that that helps him too much. I can't advance my own pieces. Oh, wait, now I'm hanging my knight. Well, that makes things more exciting. Yeah, right, so queen f7 was predicted. Or I predicted it, rather than saying it was predicted. It was foretold that queen f7 would occur. So, yeah, I'm going for a draw. Both queens are pinned to both kings, so this is the best we can do. So that's a round one draw. For 5 rating points. All right, 1 hour 54 minutes to go. At some point I should probably study the openings for this variant. I know that Bishop D4 is a strong opening. Oh crap. Whatever. I just hung a piece for no reason. We'll just call it inventing an opening. So how do I make the best of this situation? How indeed. All right, well, let's just keep taking things. What's the worst that could happen? Other than my opponent winning. All right, let's go king go. Yeah, I mean, I tend to do that a lot. Every player needs a signature move, and apparently mine is just hanging your pieces for no reason. And then finding a way to rationalize it. I mean, you could be all down on yourself and be like, oh man, I shouldn't have hung that piece. Oh no, my game's gonna be so horrible from now on. Or you could just take it with stride and say, yep, I hung a piece. It was an awesome move. Okay. So I've got to find a way to stop his king. Oh, he's actually going to help me out here. Again, he can't check me because this is racing kings. Check is illegal. So I just need to find a way to keep developing and not panic and just keep making progress. I'm actually going to retreat for a brief instant there. Oh, I'm going to win on time. See, my masterful strategy is winning again. So I just block with a knight and my king races forward. I don't know why my opponent went berserk that game if he wasn't comfortable playing quickly. I suppose my hanging pieces strategy was just too strong for him. Yeah, that was it, for sure. So that puts me in eighth place. Yeah. Okay, so this time we're gonna play. Can I play click click move? Just def. Oh, okay. Click click. There's my move. Apparently, I'm playing black this game. I'm not sure how I'm supposed to know that I was playing black. Oh, I can see it over here. Okay, that's how I'm supposed to know. So you can't play bishop takes rook because that would be check. Okay. He ensures that. You know? Let's just take this rook and see what happens. I'm almost tempted to sack my queen. Doesn't seem quite worth it. Okay, let's get my bishop out of harm's way and do something about his king. No, this knight can't move. Not that he wants to move that knight, he wants to move this one. So my queen's no longer hanging. I am indeed attacking the knight. If he does queen takes queen, that would be check, so my queen's kind of safe where it's at. Oh, goodness, how did I miss that? Well, do I run for it? Running seems fun until it doesn't work. Then it's less fun. Okay. Oops. Well, okay, again, this is just a gambit. Everything's fine. Yeah, no, I'm completely lost. Back to tournament. I knew I should have double-checked before making that move. Well, we're 10 minutes into the tournament and have already lost any chance of winning the event. And game by game, more people are joining, so our chances continue to dwindle. How about that? Okay, that's a free knight. I'll just take all the things. Oops. Oh, well, that's actually a bit more challenging than I thought. So just make sure A7 is, or B7 is amply guarded. Right. So that's his master plan here, is to somehow place a piece on the B7 square and just race his king to the other end. And it just might work. I have not calculated this to the end. So it's very possible I've missed something. Okay, he's gonna play rook takes knight. And now he's gonna attempt rook takes bishop and see. Oh, he can't take the bishop. What a shame. He could do knight takes bishop. Oh, instead he's opting to, I don't know what. Something. I can't take that. Let's just keep moving the king forward. That can't be bad. Let's see. How crazy am I feeling here? Oh, my queen's A-okay where it stands. See, I can get away with this, although that's risky. Makes much more sense for me to play this. Okay. I hope you have a plan, because you just gave away your rook. And you gave away your bishop. So I'm just saying, I hope for your sake you've got a plan, buddy. Yep, so now he's got to move his knight and frantically hope that there's something in this position. Oh yeah, that was it. I felt bad for him. That's the reason for the resignation. It couldn't possibly be like me being down a million pieces. And by a million, I mean just too much to recover from. There we go. A 17 move victory. Yeah, we're playing Racing Kings without an increment. But you know, if we win this, 15 bucks. This is fun. So we have to play it. Yeah, that's the only way for crazy people to play it. Alright, I take. Well, I can't take there. Okay. I guess I move my king forward. Onward to victory. Wait, can I take this knight? No, I shouldn't bother. That knight's threatening my bishop, though. Let's take it. So we got this kind of cool thing going on. That could be a little challenging for him to deal with. I wonder just how long it'll take for him to recognize that assembly I've got going on here. Note if he sacks the queen, I might not want to take it. But on the other hand, I might. Hey, yeah, if you could use the $5 or $15 or whatever, yeah, join the tournament. Win all your games. Don't cheat. And you just might get the money. I guess that's how it goes. Okay, so this, he cannot take the bishop because that would check my king. I could take the rook. Yeah, let's take. Ooh, that's mean. Why didn't I see that? Okay, so plan B, let's hit this queen. Obviously, he's going to play queen there or something, so I can't immediately capture it. I'm just trying to get him to move his queen so I can move my king forward. That failing, I might need to put some blocker in the way somehow. I felt that a king on g4 is useful because now he can't play knight e3 or knight f2. Both would be check. So you'd have to find some other way to develop the knight. Right. So, question here is what do I do to stop him from advancing? I guess queen i6 looks as reasonable as anything. Although here he's got rook c6, which is pretty annoying. Let's see, I guess I'll s just put the queen over here instead. Hopefully I've calculated this right. Oh, except for like missing the hanging piece again. I thought that that defended the rook, because I was first looking at bishop e3, which clearly does defend a rook. And then I found a way to hang a rook instead. Okay, here we go. Maybe. So my king is one rank behind, which is really dangerous in this variant. It would have been better for me to play knight b5, because he's not going to play king takes, and the bishop controlling b8 could be useful in some lines, and maybe even c7 could be useful. So bishop d4 is probably bad. It would have been better to play knight b5, both covering a7, giving my option, giving me the more ways to potentially cover these squares in the future. So bishop d4 was a bit hasty on the draw. I'm concerned about queen takes queen. Not that I have any choice at this point, but it's concerning. All right, we can protect the bishop. I did not seriously expect him to go backwards like that. That's pretty out there. All right, so I attack your rook. Oh, this is bad. Okay, I go back. Shit. I lucked out. I so lucked out. Okay, now we're gonna cover this from the other side. Then go back over here. Oh, this is bad. Yep, this is bad. I lose. You got me. Well, it's for that sort of thing that I'm not going to win the event. In hindsight, well, there's a whole lot of things I could have done better, but I'm losing to a 1700. There are players rated about 2000 playing in this, and I have not played it much, and I don't know the openings that well. I don't know if anybody does. I just know you're supposed to do this, and then, like, bring your king out, and that's about it. Unfortunately, other players have kind of wisened up to this sort of thing. So I need to stop being so greedy in the opening and just, like, get my king out here. Actually, taking the bishop puts me at some disadvantage, too. Here, let's develop the bishop this way and just run. What's so bad about running? That's what's so bad about running, is it just doesn't work. We'll take one of these. So I've got A6 covered. Can I sing something? Nope! Cannot sing anything. I mean, no. A dance. Ooh. All right, but how do you know that I'm not already dancing? Right, free queen. Free rook. And just plunk a rook over here. Put my bishop over there. I think I got this. I think I have a small material advantage in this position. I mean, how many queens do you want me to hang? Have I not hung enough material for you guys to be satisfied? How many times do you need me to blunder for it to be entertaining? Oh, lichess got talent. You know, at some point, I should just put on like that music website, that iJam.space thing that National Master Zug Attic put together. Should just have that going in the background. Oh, I made this theme. You can apply this user style just using your browser plugin, and visiting the site, and it's just CSS. All right, here we go. Oh, he stopped my king. That was mean. I have no idea if this is good or bad. Maybe I should have done the bishop there instead of the knight. Okay, here we go. King. See how fast this king can race. I can't move the knight because I'd check myself. Let's defend the and then I can interpose with the bishop here. But I'd want to delay that until, say, I've got some more pieces covering squares up here. Probably don't want to hang my queen for nothing. I mean, I might, just to make things exciting, but it's better to hang it for something than for nothing. I guess that's a good square for the queen, maybe? Maybe not. Alright, knight ed4. Oh, he's gonna try to attack my queen again. Here. I'll attack your queen first. Okay. I'm not gonna make this easy. Oh, I should not have allowed that, because I still cannot advance my king. This is bad. This is horrendous. All right, so we're gonna go back and cover this. Although we're not really covering it that well. Yeah, you can just play that anyway. I still can't move this knight. I can move my king forward. So I'll play what I can. As for how I cover these other squares, I'm not sure. Yeah, this is kind of an unmitigated disaster. Well, we're hanging a rook. and probably a whole lot more. So stay tuned for that. Oh, I can't go there as night covers everything. If I cry Jumanji, do I win? Because I could use something like that right now. I mean, this is so horrendously lost, and I'm down on time. So, we'll see if I can pull this out somehow. Oh, there goes my queen. Yeah, this might not be going my way. Oh, he wins. Good, it's over. Yeah, this is a serious prize money tournament. So all the sandbaggers can come out and claim the prize. And just because there are no classes, so starting with a low rating offers you no advantage. But yeah, people tend to do really well when there are incentives to do well. Okay, we're going berserk, guys. We are going so berserk. Alright, let's go king! There's no way this can fail. I think I'm already lost. I'm probably already lost. Let's find out. Oh, that bishop can't be captured. Knight takes bishop either way would be check. That's spectacular. Okay, do knight takes knight, I guess? Or rook takes whatever, I don't care. My king runs. He runs like, I don't know. Make up your own metaphor, insert it here. And he say that he runs like that. Okay, we're gonna take this before we run out of pieces. Oh, also, actually what we're threatening is Queen C7. Yeah, that was the threat the whole time. The goal is to just get your king to the other side. It's that simple, and yet that complicated. Only nuance is you cannot check your opponent. And you cannot put your king in check, of course. So like, when I play knight f2 there, that's illegal. Which I clearly did for illustrative purposes only, and not because I actually wanted to play knight f2. Okay. We're gonna get the king to the 8th rank, maybe. Probably not. But we can dream. Hey, look. That's a free piece. Here we go. I might have confused him. There we go. And I win. There's no check, even, so you cannot checkmate. You just have to get your king to the other side. So yeah, after a half hour, I stand in 14th place, which is about, well, I started in 2nd place, so I dropped 12 places in this tournament, and I lost 33 rating points, which is one rating point for every minute that I've been playing. So at this rate, by the end of the tournament, I will have lost 120 rating points. Hopefully that doesn't crash, or doesn't crush the system. Okay. Knight takes bishop, still illegal. Yeah, I don't know what to do. I'm out of ideas. Here we go. Queen H8. Knight takes, maybe? I don't know. Okay, which knight do I not want going where? I can't tell. I'm just gonna boldly march my king toward the center and hope that was the bright or the correct decision. Okay, just keep going, King. You can do it. Have faith in yourself. Ignore the fact that rook is threatening to take on e6, should you plant the knight there. Oh, yeah, no, I'm playing in this. It's still ongoing. Okay, so I'm just three measly squares away from victory. And might as well be 300 for how close I'm actually gonna get. Okay. Hang on. I can afford to do things like this, I think. If not, we'll know very soon. But I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. Okay. Sure. I'll take your rook. You can't take mine because that would be check. So that kind of puts black as a disadvantage, I think. It's not so easy to tell, to be honest. Okay, yeah, just keep moving your queen. And I'll keep doing the same, and we'll just keep shuffling queens and see who ends up where at the end of the day. Note that he kept. Yeah, he's finally lined up as rook and king, which is something you want to do pretty often in this game. Okay. Let's see where he goes. If he goes to a5. Oh. Well, that's easy. Sure. Yeah. I think you forgot that my queen was defended. What's with me in spotting free hanging pieces? That's quite unlike me. Oh, variance pots are in third here. So yeah, very well played, this event. That's pretty amazing. Okay, so right off the bat, I'm winning a queen. We'll see how well that serves me. Let's see if I find some way to squander it. Oh, I can't check. Okay. Here, let's set up a defense. I don't know. Which rank? Pick a rank. Eighth rank. So that defends my knight because my king's in line with the knight. If he moves his king, I can start capturing some of his pieces, unless we step into that pin. Okay, let's put another rook out there. He's probably going to play king b5 to sustain this pin. All right, so how do I develop? That knight's actually really annoying. I guess I have to move my bishop out of the pin. I still can't move the knight. Oh goodness. We have gone into very confusing territory. Or unfamiliar territory, I should say. Might not be that confusing, I just don't know what's going on. It's more of a subjective than objective assessment. Okay, well, I'll prepare rook takes c6. Still not sure where we're going. Also, I have knight takes c1 in the cards, but I'm not sure that that helps. Okay. So now. Yeah, now I get to move the king forward. Oh, he takes my knight. Oh, that could be a problem. That could be a problem. Maybe I want to do knight d4 before he takes this. Although then he plays rook d6, but no, I think I'm okay. His knights can't go anywhere on this side of the board because my king's in a light square. They're both on light squares. As they start going places, it's going to check. So I have a tempo that to burn, and that's a good way to burn it. Queen g2 looks nice, but I'm not sure what it does. I'm much more concerned that his king is two ranks further up the board than mine, and he's on move, so this could go south very quickly. I predict rook f6. Oh, incidentally, if he plays rook f6, I just take it, because knight takes f6 is not a thing. See, having a knight in the center is actually really confusing for both players. Having two knights in the center makes things even more confusing. Yeah, I understand him wanting to get rid of this knight. So he could play rook c6 safely. I might just allow him to do that. I can get something out of it, and I think I can. Okay, you're I don't know if I'm gonna take you up on that. Here, take my queen. So my plan is just to move the king into the corner. I'm threatening bishop takes rook. Bishop takes rook it is. He's got knight takes f6. She didn't play. Knight takes f6 would have put up a lot more resistance. King from tunneling into the corner when there's two blockers there. Bishop takes bishop. If you play bishop takes, I get to play king h7 and there's still no stopping me. Okay. That was a valiant effort. Hey, look, I made it in the top 10. You know, I could just withdraw and watch Penguin GIM1 play. Because he's rated like 300 or 200 points. 250 points higher than me. Ooh. Okay, sure. Let's go berserk. I lost my pinning piece, so I'm gonna recapture, and you're gonna show me what's wrong with this. Okay. Okay. Sure. So what's the big, what's your point? Oh crap. Okay, this could have gone a lot better. All my pieces are hanging, and I'm playing an international master. How do I make a game of this? Yeah, this might not be going well. For those who haven't noticed, being down, like, a zillion pieces does not actually help you in this game. Okay, I'm just gonna keep developing. Something positive might come of this someday. Maybe. Probably not. So he's got to try to find a way to... Oh. Wait, what? Oh, right, because now I don't have anything I can do. Yeah. Okay, you win. GG. I could just watch him play for an hour. Like, what am I doing trying to get first in this tournament? I'm not going to be able to... outcalculate an international master when I'm missing one move hanging pieces. I mean, it could be fun playing, but I shouldn't have any expectations of victory. Let's just keep going. Go, King, go. Wait, was this good or bad? I probably should have asked that before moving instead of after. But you know, if I play fast enough, maybe I can just feel like it was the right thing to do. Who needs objectivity when you can have subjectivity? Hang on, let's take the rook. Hit the queen, and that way we can have some active knights. Okay. Well, I've cut off his king, so I just need to hang my queen again. Just keep repeatedly hanging the queen until I can finally get my king to move forward. Or until he actually carries out a threat like that. I think I'm okay? Maybe I'm not? I can't really... Oh. I am not okay. That's definitely not okay. So wait, knight d3 does not cover anything near what needs to be covered. This could be bad. Yeah, this could be very bad. Well, at least I'll get to take his rook. There we go. I got his rook. It looks like free points got some free points off of me. So this whole racing your king and ignoring all your hanging pieces just doesn't work very well. I should focus more on the taking pieces side of things, and less on the trying to race your king to the other side as quickly as possible Which doesn't seem to be working very well. Okay. I'm gonna take the rook. And hopefully not get mated. Oh wait. My king can't exactly make it past this battery now, can it? Thankfully, my opponent squanders a useful tempo. Unfortunately, it's difficult for me to attack the queen without losing material. Okay. I can at least try to complicate things. Sure. I mean, this looks horrendous, and it probably is. Wait. Oh, he's intending rook g8, rook f8. What do I do about it? I mean, he's got other threats too, but that's the primary threat. Okay, we're gonna hang the queen. Just because we can. And hopefully this is gonna work out. Oh, I can't play rook h8. Okay, this is suddenly not looking as good. Sure. Yeah, this tournament is kind of, I don't know. It's an experience. Oh, he played, well, he can't move the bishop. But he could, like, put any piece whatsoever on f8 and he'd be winning this. I have no way of stopping it. I have no way of even advancing my king a single square, let alone two. And I'm blocking all my squares. But I did stop rook g8. So we'll note that. We gotta enjoy the minor victories while they still last. Okay. We're delaying the inevitable for another turn. He just plays knight takes knight. Okay, how do I delay this inevitable disaster as many turns as possible? Yeah. Here's how we delay it. We just resign. There's no coming back from that. Being down the queen and losing the rooks and down with even more material to follow. Here, let's go berserk. That's got to be good for morale. Okay. I'm going to take your bishop. I'm going to take... Oh, I can't take that. I'll take the queen. So, going berserk in hindsight might not have been the right thing to do against this fellow. Because now I have to get out of the pin. Wait, what? Why would you do king there? He's made his task a lot more challenging than it needs to be. Okay, so just play another piece to that rank. Just try to delay this block as much as we can. And the knight in the center is not terrible, and it could be a useful blocker later on. Oh, I guess also I'm double attacking the rook. Just in case anybody's keeping track of tactics back home. That one's called a double attack. No, if he does rook takes, I can't recapture. But that doesn't. Rook takes doesn't help him anyway. Okay. I'm really not sure what that's about. So, he's got a pretty undesirable position here. The main thing in his factor is the clock. Glad my mouse worked. Also, my brain worked. Yeah, I just need to go berserk more often. That's it. Who cares about blunders when you're going berserk? Certainly not my opponent. All right, I've got the black pieces. Yeah, let's go berserk again. That worked great last time. Couldn't possibly fail. Unless it does. Okay. This might not be going well. Oh, I can't even take it there. I've got to take here instead. Hang on. That's a pin. Okay. Sure, maybe, I don't know. This might not, this really doesn't look so hot. Okay, that's another pin. You know, if I get stalemated, this is a draw. So if I play Queen G5, am I getting stalemated? Okay. Evidently not. Wait, if I take the rook and play King A7, I'm not winning. I can't. Oh dear. Yeah, this doesn't look so good. Oh, I lost on time. That was such a close game, too. Other than being down two rooks, two bishops, and a queen, that was a pretty close game. All right, let's go berserk again. Oh, that's not a hanging piece. That's a sacrifice for initiative. The chess gods give and the chess gods take. Oh, well, I guess I can take one of those, right? Okay. Oh, my rook's hanging. I managed to not hang the rook. That's one piece this game I didn't hang. Here, let's defend the queen and the bishop. And this is what makes the variant so confusing. So now the knight's pinned. Alright. Well, I can't move my queen. Bummer. Well, let's defend it, I suppose. Make the best of a bad situation here. Okay, keep this knight pinned if we can. All right, I can just deflect his queen away. Unlike normal chess, here you can just. This is the square I want. I'll see if I can somehow manage to get it. So there we go. Sure, why not? All right. And there's the time win. Okay, 13th place, 12 to go to the top, 11 to go to get in the money. Probably not going to get in the money today. Yeah, these tournaments really make you think. I'm still trying to remember what's so terrible about playing this symmetrically. I think it's just you play King E5 and White's far better, but I don't remember if there's anything beyond that to consider. Also, Knight takes F1 looks tricky. But yeah, these bishops that span the length of the board. Oh, I forgot to go berserk. These make the game make this a bit more challenging for both players, I guess. Or no, for black. He's, I don't know, at a loss to get past all this. And there's still this pin. I really like this pin. Without it, that start position would not be nearly as entertaining as with it. Okay, that looks like a free knight. I bet he was expecting me to move this bishop away and just let his king run up the board. I'm not gonna go down without a fight, though. Okay. I guess this is how I'm defending that bishop. This is pretty weird. I don't want to just take this outright, because that would give him a tempo. This rook back on b1 is not as useful as a rook up on b6. All right, and he realizes that too, and he lifts it. But I'm not sure that the lift helps him too much. So I hit your queen. you're probably going to block that attack. Or you might move the queen away. But now my king is free to advance. Do I want to advance right away, or do I want to keep this pin here a bit longer? I think I like that pin. Trouble is, my bishop on c6 is really feeling the heat there. Here, I'll do this so that I gain a tempo later. My idea being rook g7, and then just race my king up this way, and you still can't capture my queen. It's kind of a vague idea, and hopefully the sack is worth it. Alternatively, I could have just taken on b6, which would have made a lot more sense. But why play the sensible move when you could play the risky one? Okay. There was no reason for him to take that knight. I mean, other than just being frustrated with the position, there's no reason I can imagine to take it. Okay, one more step. But it might as well be a million. Well, no, I think I actually have this here. Yeah, one more step and we're golden. So I kind of lucked out. Nice. Still, I'm nowhere near the money. It might be more fun to just watch the top players play it out. In particular, this Penguin IM guy seems to really know what he's doing. Right. But where's the fun in watching when you can play? Oh, man, at some point I should reinstall that auto go berserk script. It makes these games a lot sillier. Okay, if King A4, I just take. Oh. Yeah, now we actually get to see this, and his queen's trapped. I might be ahead here, ever so slightly. And he can't take my rook, because that'd be check. Still can't take my rook, because it would be check. Oh, we could play knight takes rook. What am I talking about? Okay. But yeah, this rook on b7 is going to be kind of tricky for him to dislodge. Two rooks on the seventh rank are even more difficult to dislodge than one. And if I could somehow get a third rook there, that would make it even more difficult. So, this is the plan. Not sure what he's intending to do about it. Here we go. Oh, gotta slow the plan just a touch. Okay. Well, good luck, buddy. Just might need it. Cool. So I guess after an hour, blunders do get made. Okay. I'm gonna assume that rook b7 is a fine starting move. Why did I think that knight takes queen was check? Am I high or something? Oh, goodness. This might be bad. It might be okay, but the odds of it being okay are slim to far less than slim. Okay, we're gonna run for it, guys. Okay, now this is busted. This is supreme busto. I hung my queen on move two. Yeah, winning the event might be a little bit tricky. This penguin I am guy, I have a lot of respect for him, I guess. Alright. I have the black pieces. Sure, let's go berserk. Going berserk has never shot us in the foot before, and never will again. Okay, let's spin the rook. Take a bishop. Oh, I can't take the other bishop, so let's just plunk a rook on the 8th rank. Plunk the other rook on the 7th. And I guess at this point, start running. So I'm doing what I can to provide cover for this bishop back here. While still trying to do some sort of interference with his promotion idea. Well, that's actually good. That's clever. Okay, what do I do? I guess this is kind of forced. I'm not sure how far I get. If he plays rook g5, I'd take f1. And that would pin his pieces. Okay. Still trying to stop rook g8 from happening. I might succeed in that endeavor. I suppose hanging d5 is not the worst thing in the world. Also, I could have taken this bishop. Although that doesn't benefit me. Oops! Well, shit. This is really risky. This is needlessly risky. Well, we're gonna pre-move queen takes. Holy moly. Yeah. I don't like this anymore. Let's go. Right, pre-move King A8. That seems unstoppable. You have to sack his queen on D8 to stop me. I just take it and then still unstoppable. So yeah, I lucked out. Cool. Right, we're going berserk again. Interesting. Knight to b3. I've never seen that played there. I wonder how good it is. Well, I think that's GG. I'm pretty sure there's no breaking through at this point. I mean, he could play King A6 or there, but he can't get to either of the top two ranks on the board. So, yeah. Okay, sure. Yep. Okay. Yep. And now what? Okay. Yep. Well, at least that went quickly. I've got black. All right. Yeah, maybe I just need to just take all the pieces more often. Oh, I can't take F2. Okay, F2 is still. Wait, can I not take that? I tried that like four times before I successfully played it. I blame my mouse. Oh, we've got to block. Ooh, this is kind of a mess, honestly. Huh. Apparently, I have lost the game. He's doing Queen F8 next, isn't he? If I play Rook B8, he does Queen F8. If I move my king up, he does Queen G or Rook G8. Rook G8's not so decisive. We're gonna have to play the odds here. Still, this is not good. So I do that to stop Queen F8, which would now be check. As long as I don't lose both rooks, I can still sort of put up a fight. Oh, right, I forgot he's got Rook F8 here. To which my only possible reply is Bishop H7, and I'm still dead lost. Yeah, GG. You got it, pal. Yeah, these people who play this game are good at it. What did he even do that game? He played some original move and I got really confused. Number 1 versus number 87. That's an original pairing. All right, we got free points again. I'm gonna give him some free points, but we're first gonna go berserk. Okay, so we're gonna try King H3. Since some opponents seem to be having great success with this King H3 thing, it just might work for me. I'm not sure how. It might. Okay, here we go. Sack the queen. Didn't need it anyway. That was actually an intentional queen sack as opposed to most of my queen's axe. This one might be good. This might be inspired by some of my early testing against Stockfish in the variant. Oh, and it could just be a crock of nonsense. One can really never know these things, you know? I say as. Wait, no, I'm actually fine here. I'm A-okay. I was about to fib about how I could have just been completely making that up. But now I look kind of awesome for having beaten free points. Man, I feel bad for him though. He was on a roll. He was winning tons of games. And these last few games, he's not been doing so hot. So yeah, this King H3 thing, it's got some merit to it. It's a lot trickier than King G3. Of course, that's because everybody plays King G3, so this King H3 thing is just confusing. It's not my move. I've got the black pieces. Okay. Did not expect that, so we'll just take a piece on move one. And stop his king from advancing. See how many threats I can make in a row that he has to respond to. He still can't take this with the knight. Oh, he did take it there, though. He's making some progress. How do I progress? Do I really have to play this? I think I really have to play that. Okay. I'm just gonna run. Hopefully running works. It like never works, but hopefully this time it'll be fine. Oh crap. I hung my everything. This might not be so good. All right, here we go. It's the moment you've all been waiting for. Sure, why not? How do I try to stump him? So, if my knight's pinned, it can't actually take the rook. Alright, this slows his king for a tempo and allows me to threaten bishop e8, which wins on the spot. And he didn't see it, so GG. Cool. I think I might have still had some good chances there. I'm not sure. For sure, sacking his rook for the knight was ridiculous, because it meant he could no longer use both of his rooks together to block on the seventh or block on the eighth. He had to pick one or the other. He tried to pick both, and it just didn't quite work. This is interesting for sure. My king has advanced two ranks. His king has not. And I control the center. So, definitely have some initiative here. I'm just gonna take the things. I keep being afraid to take material, but being cowardly is no way to act in this variant. All right, hopefully I can barricade somehow. It's really not looking good. Prognosis is pretty bad here. Because he's threatening Queen C8. But we've got Rook B8. Rook B. Oh, crap. I forgot about that. This is bad. Whatever. You want it, buddy. Bummer. What can you do? What can you do? Oh, I thought I was so clever with that Rook B2. He saw it too. He knew it before I knew it. Whatever. Okay, fine. We'll sack all the things again. Just out of frustration more than anything else. What am I even doing here? Okay, we're gonna take the knight. And then recognize that all of our pieces are pinned and we can't take anything. And it's sad. Okay, I can take this though. It's like the one thing this game that I'm allowed to take. Okay. I'm already trying to find some way to block on e5 and then be able to recapture later. It's just no good. Yeah, I have to block over here now. He's just gonna attack my queen. All right, I can't even take that. All right, so we'll play back here. Down a bajillion pieces with no initiative. And just hope it works out. Oops. Well, I just hung a knight. So that's great. Not a lot I can do here. Not a lot I can do. Oh, I can't block. I'm kind of out of moves. Fine, we'll defend the queen. Just let him take my rook. Oh, I ran out of time. What a pity. Well, I think that about does it for this event. Eighth place isn't too bad. We see that things are just kind of degenerating at this point. So I'll just wish Penguin and all these fellows and free points just the best of luck with the rest of the event. And that's Racing Kings in a nutshell. Yeah, we're not forced to play it all out. If we were, that would be kind of brutal, especially because there's no payment for actually participating. There's no participant award. So, I don't know. Hopefully, I've learned something from it. Probably not. I just probably need to play this a lot more to better appreciate what's going on. But it's been fun practicing, anyhow. Here, thanks for watching. For those watching our other participants streaming, you're probably enjoying it more at an academic level and less at a just Friday night, just playing a tournament on a whim. Oh, look at me, look, I'm hanging all my pieces, sort of level. Which can be kind of fun too from time to time, but whatever. That's Racing Kings. I wonder if anybody's ever going to compile some strategy to it, or if it's just going to be all about tactics. For sure, it's really challenging, and not the sort of thing I was looking forward to on a weekend, but decided to press a little bit out there and see, just, can I make anything beautiful, interesting of it, and I don't know, and that endeavor, I might have made some progress, but as far as trying to win the event is going, that ship has sailed. I'm not winning this. Not even close. These guys are pros. Somehow I manage. I'm still over 1900. That's an achievement. That's my achievement here. Is that I managed to stay in the top 10. Managed to stay over 1900. But yeah, to progress, I've got to put a lot more effort into it. And not hang so many pieces. And I'm sure I could do it, just give it time and practice. Which, yeah, that's a thing that can be done. That said, I hope you enjoyed watching. If you didn't, I'm sorry, and let me know. Is there some variant that I could play in the future that you might enjoy more? Is there some time control or something else that might be more fun? Maybe I should not play so much in this particular type of tournament, just because there's no increment. And because it tends to be time controls I don't play so often, as well as variants that I don't play so often. And it tends to attract really strong players, and that tends not to be my cup of tea, I guess. I tend to play just more for fun and to show off some endgame techniques if I can. That doesn't seem to be happening very much in this very tactical variant. So anyhow, yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.